Here we go. If you go to YouTube.
We welcome you into the PSB Tip-Off Classic right here at the SGV TV. Joel Hillsman, Jonathan Hemingway. We are here in our 10-20 bracket game. It is crossover hoops. Archie, they are in blue, and the New York Gauchos, they are in white. We had an early turnover there by the crossover hoops, and now here come the Gauchos. They will walk it into the forecourt. Swings it over to the left side. Holding it now is Rebecca Ripley. Ripley, and they'll swing it over on that right side. They're moving right to left. Ripley, a long left wing three. It rolls off. No good. Rebound hit the floor. Offensive rebound there by the Gauchos. And a long three. In and out. No. Back up Ripley with the rebound and a foul underneath. Will be inbounding it underneath for the Gauchos. And a three. Corby. Tashai Corby out of South Shore with that three, and we're underway 3-0. 4 8-minute quarters here. There's a long left wing three off the back of the iron. No good. Ripley gets the rebound for the Gauchos. They'll come back this way. The Gauchos are in white. And Hoops Archie is in blue. Out of bounds right here in front of us. Ripley will be inbounding. To check it, and Finney Hammond is not here, so we got to change to number one. So they'll kick it over to Ripley. Ripley goes baseline, stop, picks it back out, and a steal. On the passing lane, it'll be Sydney Archie with the steal. Archie on the break, stop, pop a shot. It's good. Sydney Archie with the steal and jump.
Joel, glad to join you here on the broadcast once again. It's been a couple of months since we've joined forces. But as always, a pleasure to be with you. We've got a great matchup here between the New York Gauchos and Crossover Hoops from Virginia. A couple of committed players already on the court. You mentioned Sydney Archie just a moment ago. 5'10", 2017 prospect, already given her verbal commitment to Virginia Commonwealth. You saw the range, the touch. And she is also joined along the front court, number 22, Kamari Gatling, already given her verbal commitment to George Mason.
A long three out of good ball movement. There it is. Sierra cut up a three out of Highland Springs. Sydney Archie, as we mentioned, she had that steal and came down on a jump, playing with a left brace on that left knee. There's a reverse by Ripley. It is no good. Rebound hit the floor. Now we got a loose ball foul. Loose ball foul will be on the Gauchos. And check that roster. 25 will pick up the foul. So it will be crossover basketball. They will be inbounding it. I like what I've seen already from Sydney Archie here in the first few moments. When you talk about you and I joining forces at the PSB circuit, I absolutely love it. I'm looking forward to another fun day today, and just overall the talent that this event and these events bring in, you know you're going to have some sheer fun. Long three is no good. Gauchos in transition. Good ball handling in the open floor, and a foul going up. We'll get two.
That's number 23, Selena Faluxi. We had a chance to watch her during the exhibition games on Friday. Kyle Moore and myself were on the microphone for that one, but Faluxi is quite a handful.
Yes, she is. Very nice in the open floor.
Yeah.
You saw there, even 6 foot, and will be at the free throw line.
We saw a lot of her low post game in the lane on Friday, but one of the things that I've noticed from her is exactly that transition game. She is a load going down the lane. Very soft touch, you know, even going at full speed.
And the soft touch display there at the free throw line, knocking them both in. We're tied at five. Just over 2.5 gone by. Archie holds it, kick it back. There's a jump shot, back iron, no good by Coleman. Jennifer Coleman's shot is no good. And now here come the Gauchos back this way in transition. Right hand dribble, kicks it down on the right side. There's Corby. Corby now pops it back out, and here's Faluxi. Faluxi showing the handle, goes behind the back. There's a long, deep three. Good. Bottom of the net. Corby, her second three of the contest. Showing the range, Hemi.
Good looking shot there. Got her feet underneath her, lined it up, knocked it down. And like you said, the second of the game. And Filoxi shooting the passing lanes once again here in transition.
Getting the steal, goes down, up counted, and the foul on the break. We talked her up, and now she's shining, and will go to the free throw line and try to complete the end one. Read the passing lane, as you mentioned. Cut in, stole it. We saw that open floor ability, came in and got the end one.
Great anticipation on the backside of that 2-3 zone. And when she gets going downhill, might as well just get out of the way because it's a three-point play waiting to happen.
And there it is. She completes the three-point play and quickly up to 5 points. And the lead balloons out to six quickly, a 6-0 run. 11-5, just under 5 minutes to play. 4 8-minute quarters. I like the adjustment this summer.
You like it?
I love it. Basketball to me is a quarters game. Here's Archie, a long two. Good. Sydney Archie, toe on the line, and she gets the two.
Great looking form there by Archie from the perimeter. Got great size, but showing that she can knock down the long range jumper as well.
Ripley went baseline. It was cut off. Passing lane was shot, and a steal by crossover hoops. Now they got battle on the floor. Good job hustling. Filoxi was down there battling with Jennifer Coleman. Jennifer Coleman, 5'8", Highland Springs High School out of Richmond, Virginia.
Been impressed with the backcourt. Now, obviously, you know, we're going to talk a lot about the front court of Archie and Gatling, you know, at the forward and center positions. But the backcourt tandem of Coleman and Kudrup, I've been a fan of for a couple of years. First saw them back at our PSB Elite 32. And that pass a bit errant. But what I like about them is they're both kind of combo guards. They can both handle a little bit. They can both shoot and play create. Right on cue, Coleman with the steal and the lay-in.
Making up for the mistake. And they look like a very confident bunch. And when you get easy baskets right there, Jennifer Coleman, as she did, that can get them going. A little bounce in the step. Good ball movement from the Gaucho. Ripley, a left wing three. It is no good. On the offensive glass, they get the rebound. Kick it back out. Here's Filoxi. Hard dribble. Goes up with the right hand front iron. No. Rebound kicked out for now. Here comes Hoops Archie in transition. Cutter could not handle the pass all the way. They fight for it on the floor. Good hustle and a jump ball. That'll go to the Gaucho. Good job there as Cutter bobbled it in transition. And that allowed the Gauchos to come in and tie her up. Corby on the inbound. She's got a pair of threes, and Filoxi with 5 points. The scoring right now, 11-9, and they cut that little 6-0 run off in a 4-0 spurt. There's a floater off the window, rolled in and out, went down the pipe. Ripley a rebound and goes up on the other side. Rebecca Ripley, 6 foot out of New Hampton.
Good offensive put back there by Ripley. She's given her verbal commitment to the University of Miami. Head coach Katie Meyer. Number 21 in white, you're looking at her.
Filoxi holds it after the pass was deflected. The Gauchos have had early good ball movement and running it through that high post right there to Filoxi. Filoxi dips and dudes and fouled underneath. And I like her attack, drawing the foul now. Each time she's got the basketball and went to make a play, she's drawn the foul and we're going to the free throw line again.
Tell you what, Joel, you and I, big NBA basketball fans, you might even be a fanatic. Might give that label. She's got a little Zach Randolph in her game, doesn't she?
Yes.
You know, good.
Just a right-handed version.
Yeah, you know, yeah, right-handed version of a Zach Randolph, but the nimble feet, but the strong upper body.
Wonderful comparison. And by the way, speaking of the NBA, as Filoxi made both of them, you said in November Golden State would win 70, so you called it.
Hey, man, good memory. You said
I like it. You said it. I directly asked you, and you said it. And when you answered me, I was like, dang, they are. Your knowledge and just knowing your good outlet pass there, I knew it. When you said it, and they did it.
I know it pains you. My brother, who is also named Joel, is a big Chicago Bulls fan. I'm a Bulls fan myself, too, and I know it pains us as Bulls fans, you know, to relinquish that 72-win title. But, hey, man, what they're doing right now has never been seen before.
It hasn't. I was okay with them tying it. but breaking it, yeah, that's what it was. But, yeah, good basketball, and they put on a show yesterday as well. And that's what you like about just basketball, what you're able to do, the transitioning of the games.
Right.
And that nature, we see it a lot with the three-point shot now, even in the travel circuit, but just the evolution of the game overall. Crudup, nice move, catching the inbound, goes up, shot, no, and it's fouled.
if Crossover Hoops going to make a run here, if they're going to win this game, they're going to need some production from their guard spots. Saw the drive there by Crudup. That's what she can do. Her and Coleman both, you know, very solid ball handlers. Obviously, they're going to get a lot of points. You know, we mentioned, you know, Archie and Gatling up front, but they're going to need double-digit, you know, points from their backcourt positions, you know, if they're going to make a run at the Gauchos here.
Crudup at the free throw line, hit the first one. Back iron on the second one. Rebound now that'll come down. 32. Foul called on Sydney Archie. 15-10. .204 to go. And you love the game of basketball. We say game of runs, and it has been a little back-to-back spurts. Long inbound pass, almost into the backcourt. Barely stayed inbound. Now going to stop. Shot off of the left elbow. Forced it up. No good. Faloxi on the rebound. Turns and puts it off. No good. Archie tipped the rebound, and we've got a whistle. Also a change here. Hemi, as you know, I get settled in here at PSB. The move to three refs.
Well, that is an adjustment specifically for this April evaluation period. You'll notice a couple of evaluating referees, you know, pacing up and down. This is a training camp, I guess you could label it for many of these referees. Not that they're rookie refs, but they are, you know, refs with some experience. You see Archie on the turnaround that are – looking to get evaluated and also trying to get bids, you know, to referee at the college level, many of them.
And hone their skill.
And they're getting immediate feedback.
In game.
Yeah. Yeah. And so when you look at it for the quality of refereeing, all of these referees have got to be on their A game. They got to be on their toes, you know, because they can't just be blowing calls all the time, because that's going to cost them money in the future.
And actually just raising the level of what the PSB events are. And that just adds to the quality, because we know we have the talent here. You have the coaches here. And you want the game to be real, because it is a real basketball game. And their feedback, they need the reps just as the players need the reps.
No question. The one thing, the one downside to this is sometimes that whistle gets blown just a little bit too much for my liking. But you know, if you have to choose between the whistle being blown too much versus not enough, and it being kind of a bloodbath, you know, as sometimes happens with summer games, I think that you would err on the side of safety.
Yeah. And the whistle, sometimes I think it all blows for us a little bit, especially if we like a little contact.
Yeah.
But then, you know, that's a part of basketball, adjusting to the whistle as well.
Sure thing.
Faloxi missed her first free throw. Missed them both. So she hit her first five free throws. Now she's missed two in a row. 15-10. We've been stuck on it. 64 seconds to go here, first quarter. The Gauchos taking on Crossover Hoops Archie. Substitutions have been made. They go to the bench. Maya Coleman now out of Lloyd C. Byrd into the contest, as well as Ariana Taylor. Taylor going to pull a right wing three. It's going to be offline. No good. Faloxi there on the glass. And here come the Gauchos again. Corby. A jump is no good. Rebound ripped down. And a long outlet pass. Nice pass. One hard dribble. Good way to get back defensively. Ran right in. Oh, it is a serious event. Ty Fotog is here. There you go. Live and in person right there under the basket. Ty Fotog took that hit.
Yep. If you want to see the best photos in the game,
man,
you got to follow at Ty Fotog on his Instagram page. Now, he does some stuff on Twitter, but his Instagram page, man, it's live, man.
It's beautiful. He's going to have a nice shot here at the free throw line. Is Camille Downs. Downs free throw, no good. We'll get one more. 36 and 2:10 seconds. Second free throw short. No good. Missed them both. Did you open the door?
Yeah, maybe a little bit of a breeze there. She didn't take account for that.
Did not look good. All right. Crossing the timeline and spins it over to the left side. There's a long, quick left wing three. No good early there in the possession. Graves. Shanice Graves missed it. And now here comes crossover back this way. Christina Lindenfeld into the contest now. They've gone to the bench and they whistle.
I think they got a double dribble there. Okay. Turnover either way.
17-5, 10-second. Missed that call. But they will walk it up now and possibly hold for the last shot. Had good ball movement earlier in the quarter, Hemi, but now
right.
kind of settled down into catch and shoot mode.
One of their best possessions, as you see this three on the way, just short, was when they got it from side to side quickly, hit the high post, kicked it out, and when number three for the Gauchos hit, and that was Corby, hit her three. That's when they're best. So they'll try to settle back into that rhythm heading into the second.
End of the first quarter, 15-10. The beginning of the second quarter, 15-10. Remember, we've moved to quarters here in the PSB event. This is the PSB Tip-Off Classic live from Lawrenceville High School, Lawrenceville, Georgia, in Central Gwinnett High School. Wow, I went back. Lawrenceville High School, that is ancient. Joined by Jonathan Hemingway, who's now at the table to check the book we had to make sure we had the correct names here. There's a few roster changes here to the Gauchos. Crossover, though, they've got it, and they're in the possession. Moving down this way. Stop over in the corner. It was Taylor. And a traveling violation called by Taylor. Arnae Taylor, and there's a three by Ripley. Ripley cracked a three. Rebecca Ripley, 6 foot, as I mentioned, out of New Hampton High School in Sagosa, Massachusetts. 18-10 now. 7:09. We're just about a minute gone by. Feeding the high post, turning. There is Lindenfeld with a turnover and a steal. Now here come the Gauchos this way. Here's Ripley. Ripley took the contact, flipped up with the left hand, and won. A beautiful move by Rebecca Ripley. She took the contact and the foul.
Ripley, good back-to-back possessions here for the Miami commit, showing her long-range specialty the previous possession, and now getting it done, trying to get the three-point play the old-fashioned way. You can see why Coach Katie Meyer and their staff down there likes Ripley. A lot of upside for this kid. Good size, 6 feet, can play a little bit inside, can play a lot of bit outside. She gets a quick 6 points here for the Gauchos.
Morgan. Got it. Thank you very much, Henry.
Yes, sir.
Lasiah Morgan. When Coach told me she wasn't here, I think he got his numbers mixed up, though. So we got it squared away. Lasiah Morgan. And then we've got Sabrina Clement as well. All right. Got those young ladies ready. So Morgan's shot is no good. Put back off the window. Counted. And the foul again. Selena Filoxi. Is she living at the line with the N1s?
She has arguably been the most productive player for the New York Gauchos all weekend long. I mean, she's getting it done. You talk about kids that fill up the stat sheet. Not only does she score points, but it's rebounds. We saw the steal, you know, early in the first quarter. You know, you got to love those type of players. You know, maybe they're not the kid that leads you in scoring every single time, but you know that she's going to grab 6 or 7 rebounds, 2 or 3 steals, a block shot. You got to have those players on your team to be successful.
Right now what you're saying, Hemi, is she's filling up the box score because she really is. And now 6 of 8 from the free throw line. Good pass down low to Archie. Jumper and a foul. Sydney Archie wanting to get in on the N1 party. That's her third field goal. She has 6 and an opportunity to add 1. 5-10 out of St. Catharines in Chesterfield, Virginia.
And that's what I was going to say. Speaking of filling up the box score, Sydney Archie doing the same thing, although she can't get that free throw to fall.
Ripley gets the rebound. Lead now cut in half to 12. Morgan gets it up ahead, and they'll swing it to Corby. Corby to Morgan, in to Philoxy. Philoxy goes on the baseline to Ripley. Ripley stepped out of bounds. It'll be a turnover by the Gauchos. But the Gauchos have actually now picked it back up with their ball movement, and they're getting contributions from Corby, Ripley, and Philoxy here so far. 2 minutes gone by second quarter. Crossover Archie now with more substitution. Jasmine Norman in running the point. They reel it in to Archie. Archie stopped, moved to the elbow, jumper good. I like that game. It's crisp with it, man. It's smooth, Sydney Archie.
Showing that she can play on the wing or in the high post. Good footwork there with the reverse pivot and, of course, the soft touch.
Philoxy caught it at the free throw line, makes a move, puts it up off the window. Good. Jeez.
Speaking of soft touch, Philoxy getting it done in the high post as well.
Nice pass by Morgan, tried to feed it down low, a traveling violation on Kennedy Maddox. Maddox with the traveling violation.
What you're seeing here on both sides, both teams in a 2-3 zone, but both offenses doing a good job of attacking the high post, the free throw line area, and getting some easy shots.
I'm glad that you said that. You and I were talking before, and I love, you know I'm a big fan of CoachHemme.com, but I really love the article on zone offense.
Thank you.
I really, because a lot of people, it's easy, you know, or you fall into the lull of the zone defense where to counteract that is the offense, and that was an excellent piece, Henry.
Thank you. For all of those out there, coaches, players, or otherwise, maybe parents, take a look at CoachHemme.com on our front page there. There was a piece that was circulated earlier on social media, as you see the Gauchos get the steal, talking about how zone defense is ruining the game of basketball. And my point was, hey, let's not focus on just the defensive aspect of it. Let's improve our offensive skills, ball movement, and shooting overall.
And see, what you've seen from the Gauchos, and we saw it early in the first quarter, they've kind of gotten back to it now, working through Philoxy
right
at the high post. And that's all it is moving that basketball. And see, and here you see she's now right there at the high post.
And putting an emphasis on passing as well, too. And you see Philoxy going to get her own shot and put back right there. There's still opportunities for kids to go to work in that kind of one-on-one matchup, which is what everybody really likes when you start talking about man-to-man defense.
Exactly.
You want to see those ISO situations. You can still get the same thing. You just have to be patient, make a couple of passes, make the defense work.
I'm just one of those things, if you keep the ball hopping, and you know, and I say one of those persons, but that's basketball, you keep the defense moving, the ball moving, it's going to open up an easy basket.
No question.
And that's what you always want to be able to get is an easy basket. There's a top side three, short, no good. Rebound ripped down Norman from the guard spot, put it back up, it's no good, and Ripley will get the rebound, and here come the Gauchos. Gauchos have them doubled up at the 3:30 mark, 28-14. And Zaya Morgan will walk in out of Capital Prep over to Ripley. Ripley on that left wing. And what they've done, they've operated. That's exactly what I was going to say, Ripley to three. She got that on a back cut one time, and
then
she's got it out there on the pass. There's a steal. Going to float it up off the window. And one. The Gauchos feeling good, getting the steal and one, putting it up with the floater is Miss Corby. She'll shoot a free throw. She has 8 in the contest.
We've been talking a lot about Philoxy working in that high post area, but let's not overlook the production that Miss Tajay Corby has been doing here from the guard spot for the Gauchos, hitting some long-range threes, been very active on the defensive end. You see her right here, transition and an opportunity for a three-point play the old-fashioned way.
And completes it. And we just to continue what we were talking about what we're seeing specifically from the Gauchos, they've only had really one forced shot.
Right. You're right.
There's a drive. Norman scooped with the left hand. No, it's batted out of bounds. Good defensive effort coming in from the Gauchos. Another change. We'll get that one. That's number 5.
And that's
we'll have substitutions.
I'm sorry, Joel. That speaks really to the veteran experience of Coach Earl Elliott over there with the Gauchos. Does a very good job of communicating what he expects from his players, getting kids to accept their roles. And that's not an easy job now, especially when you're putting together a team, you know, in just, you know, maybe over a month or maybe even less than a month sometimes.
Yeah, and see, we remind you, this is April. You know,
right.
And it, when it comes July and August, it'll be a different ball game for sure. There's a jump from the right side by Graves. No good. Ripley got the rebound. She loves using the rim to as a shield. Missed it. Started on the left and tried to finish on the right. Here's Archie. Archie gets it up ahead now, and they'll move it in with Crudup. Crudup going to drive and put it up. No, she'll get fouled with 2:28 to go.
Crudup, you see the quick first step downhill. We saw it earlier. She drew a foul earlier in the first quarter. But this zone defense from the Gauchos has really neutralized, you know, the guard attack from Crudup and Coleman. You know, overall, they've gotten some good looks, you know, from Archie, you know, in the high post. I said it before, I'll say it again. They're going to have to find some scoring in that backcourt, you know, if they're going to want to make a run at the Gauchos in the second half. And some plays like this from Crudup and the other guards are going to be important.
Front iron no good on the second free throw. She's 2 of 4 out of bounds. It will stay with crossover hoops. And we've seen now Coach Archie try to go with different combinations out of that backcourt. Now going back to the starters and Crudup and Jennifer Coleman. And each time they've kind of made a push or a momentum play, the Gauchos have came in and answered back. Good hustle there on the floor. Foul will be on Zaya Morgan. On a push, 2:21 to go, 31-15.
Not sure if you're keeping up with free throws made and miss from crossover, but you know, you've got to capitalize on those free throws for sure. And I know Crudup's miss right there was.
They are 2 of 5 as a team.
Yeah, there you go.
Check it. Camille Downs missed 2 free throws. So they're 2 of 7 as a team. Nice pass. It was tipped out of bounds and will stay with the Gauchos. And the Gauchos have only really subbed out of the guard spot. Ripley and Filozzi have gone the whole way here in this first half. There's Ripley on the catch with the left-hand dribble. Gives it over, pumps off now to Corby. Corby with the right hand spins at the top, kicks it over to Graves. Graves to Corby, good ball movement. The ball is hopping. Riley a three,
oh,
good.
Man.
Ripley a three, excuse me. It was just so good on the rotation. You saw it drop through. Tickling the twine from beyond the line.
And you heard the crossover hoops bench over here just yelling at their players, hey, find the shooter, find the shooter. But unfortunately, you know, for them, Ripley got a little bit of a look, was able to knock it down.
High low attempt, no good, and now it's going to be rebound by Ripley. Gray spins it up ahead now, and here come the Gauchos in full control of the game. And Shy Corby walked it up, 34-15, and there's a drive on the baseline and a foul. Foul will be called on the floor. On crossover.
Notice what's happening with this 2-3 zone. By putting Filozzi in the high post, they're bringing the middle girl up to defend her there, which really opens up a baseline attack from the Gauchos. That's what you're seeing right here. I think Coach Archie probably taking this timeout maybe to make an adjustment. Let's see if they keep that center position at home to take away the baseline drive.
It's a 19-point game, and as we mentioned, it just every time crossover had some play, the Gauchos came back, and they're just being very effective with their offense as we continue to harp on. But crossover going to have to tighten up defensively.
No question. You know, 34 points and a half, that's quite a bit. Give a lot of credit to what the Gauchos were doing. Ripley shot the ball well. We've mentioned Filozzi quite a bit, you know, getting work done in that high post. Of course, Corby hitting some threes, so they're going to have to tighten up. But conversely, 15 points and a half offensively is not good, so they're going to have to find some offense, some perimeter shooting, second chance opportunities, maybe even turn up the defensive pressure to see if they can turn some defense and offense here in this second half.
I like how you said that, because that's one of the things I was going to talk about. The Gauchos have kind of scored all type of ways. They scored with offense, with defense off of the turnover. They scored on second chance points. They scored in transition. It's Filozzi coming on the break again. Easy layup, no good. Rebound, tip, batted around. Crossover is going to get it. And let's see, do we have a whistle?
Uh-oh. I think we got an injury. I think it was it Crudup? No. Yeah.
Sierra Crudup, number
no,
one.
No, maybe Coleman. Crudup's down here, so it's not Crudup.
Nope, yeah, it's not Crudup. I missed that. Let's see. Lying on her back. Looks like she talking with her coach and staff.
Hopefully she just got the wind knocked out of her.
Hopefully. So not really reaching for anything and sitting up. It's Coleman.
Coleman,
Coleman.
Right.
Okay. Did not see what happened to her down underneath the basket. Take her time.
I know there was a guard drive. I don't know if it was Coleman or Crudup that drove and then maybe took a tumble afterwards. They're kind of waving her a little bit. Maybe she bumped her head a little bit.
Sitting upright, so hopefully she will be okay. 58-5, 10 seconds. It is still a 19-point ball game. And that came right out of the timeout. They were trying to score out of the timeout. Word crossover hoops. And the head coach is Torrance J. Archer. And he and his staff down there, they'll help Miss Coleman up. The Gaucho, they are huddled up. The referees reminded them to stay on the floor, so they did stay on the floor. Right there, and Coach Elliott still within his huddle, teaching.
Let's go, White. Bring him out, White. Let's
think
go, White.
She's okay. May have got hit in the face, I believe. And of course, the staff here, wonderful PSB staff also here. Make sure the young lady will be okay. All right, he'll come with the inbound now. Gatlin has checked back in. Here's Crudup into the forecourt. Crudup swings it over. Here's Hodges. Hodges now gives it in front to Gatlin. Gatlin turn. Jump is no good. Rebound will come off to Sabrina Clement. Gauchos with 41 seconds walking into the forecourt almost. Now there's a pass to Falazzi. Falazzi hesitates. Goes down the right lane. Kicks it off to the right side. Graves, a long cross-court pass to Ripley. Ripley looks into Falazzi. Now here, they're tightening up the defense just a little bit now, and Hodges coming out at the guard spot, closing and making them play further away from the basket at the moment. Putting it on the floor, Falazzi driving right, spinning back to the left. Shot is up, no good, didn't draw on. Rebound offensively, though, by Graves. 13 seconds. Corby was trapped over to Falazzi. Falazzi driving, reverse with the right hand.
Come
good.
On now.
Oh, man. That was a beautiful move. And that will be the end of the first half. A commanding first half from the Gauchos. They lead 36-15, holding crossover hoop to 5 points in that second quarter. Welcome back into Central Gwinnett High School. Joel Hillsman, Jonathan Hemingway. Second half action now coming up between the New York Gauchos and crossover hoops Archie. And a big second quarter there from the Gauchos, especially defensively. We had a 5-point game at the end of the first. They blew it open there, a 21 spot there in that second quarter, and lead 36-15. And now let me just give my corrections. Kirsten Moore, number 5. She's playing for the Gauchos, so we finally got that roster situation straight. Got it straight here for the second half. Selena Falazzi with the steal and gives it off, and they'll lose it out of bounds as Shy Corby lost it out of bounds. Corby, a pair of threes there. She has 9 points in the first half, but it is a Selena Falazzi show. 16 points in that first half from Selena Falazzi. Here's Archie. Archie kicks it to the top, and then are running it through the high post, and Lindenfeld. Lindenfeld going to drive. Left-hand layup up, no, and a whistle. Christina Lindenfeld, 6'1", out of Midlothian, Virginia. Spent some time in Virginia, but it was that 757 in Seven City. At that 804, it's Richmond in that area up there. At the free throw line is Lindenfeld. Christina Lindenfeld, first free throw is good. We mentioned the free throw shooting there in the first half. It was not spectacular. 2 of 7 from the free throw line in that first half. So now here is Lindenfeld, and she splashes home on her first two free throws. And now Ripley will get a blow, her first blow of the day, and in will be Shanice Graves. Rebecca Ripley had herself a solid first half as well with 10 points. So here is Zaya Morgan. Morgan will bring it into the forecourt, right-hand dribble, picked up defensively by Crudup. Crudup trying to reach in there. They've extended that pressure now defensively to try to change the momentum of this game here in the second half. Here's Philoxi. Philoxi going to shimmy, move. Up with the right hand, no. Offensive rebound, Kirsten, she got it blocked from behind. Kirsten still hustled, and a save and one. A beautiful hustle play underneath the basket. Kirsten Moore with the save, gave it off to Selena Philoxi, and another and one opportunity for Selena Philoxi. She has 18 in the game.
She is really showing out, isn't she, Joel?
That's just a beautiful hustle play there by Moore, who had her shot blocked but did not give up on it. Hustled underneath the basket and then got the assist. Free throw no good from Philoxi. Philoxi 6 of 9. And a hoop there, good by Lindenfeld.
I think that was Crudup.
Crudup one, excuse me.
Yeah, number one, yeah.
Crudup with the hoop.
Come on,
38-19. Here comes Big Boss. There's a drive by Morgan and a foul call. That one will be called on Sydney Archie. Now joined by Coach Chris Watkins. And Chris, what we talked about in that second quarter, it was a 5-point game. The Gauchos leading, and then they put up a 21 spot, only allowed 5 points to cross over hoop. And that's how this lead has ballooned up to where it is at 19 points, 38-19.
Yeah, no doubt. When you're going on a run like that, it's like everything's just going for you, you know, and that's what they had there in that late in that first half. And it's hard when you're the team that's getting that run just given to you. You know, you're pulling, you're grasping, you're hoping you get a stop, and then when you finally get a stop, then you can't score on the other end. And that's kind of what happened there at the end of that half.
And that's just what happened here. Tried to go on the low post past the Gatling and a turnover. Oh, Kirsten Moore will inbound it for the Gauchos. The Gauchos are in white, inbound to Philoxi. I've had fun watching Selena Philoxi play in this contest. She has dominated and lead all scores with 18 points, but there's a turnover. Transition now. Here comes crossover all the way. Put it up and one. Camille Downs. Nope, offensive foul.
Ooh.
Coach Archie.
You hate that right there because that bucket could have gotten them going on a little bit of a run.
Because it came off of a turnover. That's what you wanted to do. Here's Zaya Morgan. Morgan crosses it over, cut up on her, goes through a screen and a carry. Morgan called for Palmer. 38-19, 6-11 to go here, third quarter. Gauchos with the lead. Three. No good, Lindenfeld. Rebecca Ripley has checked back in. She had a solid first half as well, really working on the left side of the floor. Got some threes, got some back cuts. Now just got a brief blow here in the start of the second half, and she's back in. Morgan picked up by Crudup. Now here they go on the right wing here to Ripley. Ripley holds it, puts it on the floor with the left hand, off the bounce on the screen roll with Philoxi and a jump ball. Good job by Crudup coming in to force the jump ball.
Like the action they're running there on offense with the UCLA cut. Then you get the ball screen off there.
Crossover now has picked up the defense a little bit. Now are they able to capitalize? There's a pass, Arnold. Archie, a shot, Sydney Archie, no good. Rebound comes off and Corby with it. Corby gonna start the break. Corby with the right hand dribble stop, he'll peel it back now to Morgan and they'll set it up. Now Morgan to pull a long three, no good. In and out, rebound skied for and brought down by Camille Downs. Here comes Downs, stop. Right elbow, no good. Rebound now to Philoxi. back and forth in the in action at the moment. Filoxi going to go all the way, finish with the right hand off the window. Good. Just beautiful move there. She's got 20.
I like her game. You know, not afraid to get it off the defensive rebound, push it up the floor herself. She can finish around the rim. Did some really good things in the first half. You know, really showcasing herself right now on Championship Sunday in front of this baseline full of college coaches.
And they are enjoying the show they've seen from her. Been very nimble, solid from the free throw line, 6 of 9. She has 20 in the game. But the foul was on Rebecca Ripley. And at the free throw line will be Camille Downs. She's 0 of 2. She hits that one for her first free throw. Substitutions now. Mallory O'Dell will check in along with Arnae Taylor. Taylor 13 and O'Dell 30 in blue for crossover. Second free throw, no good. Camille Downs has struggled today. She's 1 of 4 from the free throw line. And now a substitution as Jennifer Coleman will check back in after getting popped in the face and banged up in that first half. Corby on the bounce, gonna drive, floated up, no good. Coleman gets the rebound for crossover. So crossover now, a chance to kind of dent into the lead. It's at 20. Bad lead pass is intercepted by Clement. Sabrina Clement intercepted it, gives it over to Filoxi. Filoxi with the right hand dribble, gonna drive, kick it over to Ripley. Ripley on the screen, gonna come right down the lane, shot no good, dumped it off Clement. No offensive foul on Rebecca Ripley. I like the variation of the offenses that New York has shown the Gauchos. They've had good ball movement with their zone offense, which we talked about in that first half. And now, as you mentioned, the UCLA cuts and getting down the lane here in the second half, changing it up offensively. They have them doubled up a 20-point lead, 40-20.
You know, unless you really have a game plan in place to guard ball screens, it's difficult to do, you know, especially at this level. And so many, especially when you talk about college and NBA, you know, in the NBA, there's like 12 different ways to guard the ball screen. And at this level, unless that's something you practice and you're not ready for it, it's hard as a player to make that adjustment.
A very sound and savvy point, especially this early in the travel season.
Exactly. You know, some people try to trap it, you go under. I mean, and they're so versatile, and especially 23 right here. You go under, they drop it off to her. She can catch it, pick and pop, and then attack on her own just like she's about to do right now.
She scored a multiple ways today in transition off the bounce. I have noticed, though, she has done all of her scoring going to the right minus a beautiful reverse move to the left earlier. So that's one thing that I've noticed. Coming back this way, Crudup going to try to force the issue. She's fouled on the shot. She'll get two. 17-point game, and they're just going to have to kind of chip away with it. 3:53 to go, third quarter. 4 8-minute quarters, and Coach Hemme and I were talking about it. Chris, I love the change to the quarters. And Brandon alluded to it last year that they might make the change, and of course we have, and I love it.
Yeah, it's amazing. I mean, and you know, you try to mirror the college game, and what I think it's good because these players are getting consistency. You've got the quarters in high school. Now they're going to have it, you know, when they move on to the four-year level. And let's take that part out of having to make that adjustment when they go to the spring season. Make that consistent so they can keep their focus on developing and getting better.
And also, I mentioned this, I think basketball is just a quarters game. That's how it's supposed to be played.
Yeah, you know, and it's different at the college, you know, when you watch like college men's, because it really is like quarters, because they've got TV timeouts and media timeouts every 4 minutes, and same, you know, that's how that's different.
Yeah.
So it's not like they're out there playing for 20 minutes without a break.
Yeah, it's broken up every 4 minutes, and you know when you're playing in March, they call it the TV timeout, but those timeouts are always there. Oh, great turn by Jennifer Coleman. And one. Her second field goal. So Coleman with the and one, and she'll go to the free throw line. It's just that when you get into the March season, the timeout is longer minute-wise. They give them an extra 90 seconds. But, yeah, it's still broken down. But the quarters game, I don't know, there's something about those quarters. All right, here's Jennifer Coleman at the free throw line trying to complete the three-point play. She does not. Filoxi on the glass. So Coleman misses her first free throw of the day. Filoxi gets it over to Zaya Morgan. Morgan with the right-hand dribble. 3:15 to go. And a timeout call. Coach Earl Elliott calls that timeout. Not pleased right now Now, as Crossover Hoops has gotten it down to 13, a little 7-0 push here. Chris just kind of chipping away.
Yeah, you know, and I want to go back and touch your point you're talking about, the four quarters.
Uh-huh.
And even then, back when I coached, you know, you treat it as almost like four mini games. Because if you get all jacked up because you're up 10, yeah. and then you come out flat in the second quarter, you come out flat in the third quarter, whatever run you had, game's over then. They yeah. go on a run. Now it's like, oh, man, you can't act like you won a championship when you won a quarter. So it's like four small games. And that's what I like here. So if Crossover can win this quarter, okay, they feel good moving into the fourth. You know, you can't get it all back. It's not MTV Rock and Jock from back in our day where there's a 20-point shot.
Yeah.
You know, you want to hit a three, maybe get a layup, get to the rim, go on a 6-0 run, maybe then 7-2 run. All of a sudden, you're back in the game.
Yep, and you do that by turning up with the defense, and we've seen Crossover now come up defense. And had they been able to capitalize on some earlier possessions, they may have been able to slice a little bit more into the lead. But right now, if you get it to 10, you're in good shape. Inbound now to Phylloxi. Phylloxi tried to feed it in to Kirsten Moore. Moore going to recover it, jump in the lane, and a foul call. And they'll call it on the floor.
You know, I feel like it's for players and in my day and when I coached, it's so much easier to get going on defense when things are going good on offense. Not to say being a front runner, but, you know, you hit a three, let's go, and all of a sudden slapping the floor, getting in the press. That's so much easier from a morale standpoint, a bench standpoint, a coaching standpoint, when you get a little bit going on O.
Especially if you struggle. There's an inbound pass and a turnover. Here comes Arnold all the way up, and let's see, Taylor. R.N.A. Taylor was fouled. She got the steal and will be going to the free throw line. And PSB tip-off classic. Glad that you're with us. Our first championship game, of the day here on SUV TV. Second half, I'm joined here by Chris Watson. Zoe Hillsman, glad that you're with us. R.N.A. Taylor at the free throw line for the first time today, and her first free throw is good. She has 4 points in the contest. Patrick Henry High, Ashland, Virginia, 5'8", and most of these are class of 2017. Take your time, second free throw is good. So R.N.A. Taylor makes both free throws. She has 5 points in the game, and look at that. Now they come with a full court press, an 11-point game, but they'll fall off. A little token pressure. Morgan, left-hand dribble into the full court, belt high, under 3 minutes to go. Gives it to Phylloxi. Phylloxi puts it down with the right hand. Archie comes out, Sydney Archie and Gardner. Now makes her move to the left. And she goes left, she passes. There's a long three, no good. Archie with the rebound. They got an opportunity to cut it down to 9. Archie fighting for it. Let's see, we've got a foul call, and I think that foul may be on Shai Corby. Shai Corby will pick up the foul. She's had herself a pretty solid game, 9 points in the contest. Sabrina Clement will be checking back in here in just a moment.
You know, slowly but surely, it's like Crossover's chipping away at this lead. They can get a bucket here, and now all of a sudden it feels like it's off your back. You know, the mountain's off your back. Things, we're under 10. Let's get a little going on defense.
Here's Coleman. Coleman to Crudup. Crudup back to Coleman. Swings it on the left wing. Puts it on the floor. Now it's Taylor. Bad pass, but it's recovered back out here by Coleman, who gives it over to Crudup. They're going to feed down left of the post, kick it a long left pass. No, going to drive Taylor, scooping across the lane, scoring good. R.N.A. Taylor coming up big with points off the bench. It's a 9-point game, and they're trapping after that press. Here's Morgan into the forecourt. They've turned it up defensively. 2 minutes to go, third quarter. Taylor on the defense goes around that screen. Morgan dribble, and a timeout called. A good defensive effort. And Coach Archie has kind of stayed the course with them. They've chipped away and got a 9-point lead. A trail by 9, excuse me. They've cut that lead down to 9. Let me get it right.
You know, speaking of comebacks, there was a heck of a one last night. I didn't get a chance to catch that Hawks-Celtics game, but I was following along. I'm sure you were probably watching it with that comeback.
I was listening to it. I caught the last 6 minutes. I watched some of the replay this morning, but, yeah, I've seen it.
You know, just talk about when things get going, go good on runs, but then you got to be able to cap that run off. And that's what's hard when you fall behind so much that when you expend all that energy to get caught back up, then you got to have that last push. So we see if Crossover can make a little bit of run here. You know, they were down, what, 18 when I got on the broadcast? Now they're down 9. If we can get a stop and get a bucket. You saw the bench got a little hype over here when they got in the press. So you just want to see if they can get that going.
And they've been able to capitalize. Now they're getting stops, and they're able to capitalize on them. Earlier they weren't able to do that. But, yeah, 19-point lead, 17-point lead last night. Good move, Ripley. And that's a good hoop coming out of the timeout there for the Gauchos. Here's Crudup. Crudup with the right-hand dribble out to Coleman. Lead pushed back to 11. They've chipped away at it, though. Baseline jump fouled on the wrist. Ripley with the foul. Crudup will be going to the free throw line. Sierra Crudup out of Highland Springs High School in Highland Springs, Virginia. Coach Archie during that timeout was also reminding them offensively, don't dribble to a spot where you're going to get stuck. He wants them to keep the ball moving. Crudup free throw, rolls off, no. Crudup 4 of 7 from the free throw line. Substitution now. Shanice Graves will come in. Rebecca Ripley will go out. Crudup, Coleman, Archie, O'Dell, and Taylor, the five on the floor for a crossover. Second free throw, no good. Now struggling and not capitalizing on the opportunities at the free throw line. 90 seconds. And a foul called on Crudup. Out high. Corby Moore, Philoxy Morgan, and Graves, the five on the floor for the Gauchos. And there's the inbound of Kirsten Moore. Kirsten going to kick it over to the right to Morgan. Morgan on that left wing now. Corby holds it high, looks, and gives it over to Kirsten Moore. Jumper, foul line, hill of the rim, no good. Rebound, tip out of bounds off of Arnold. So Sydney Arnold tried to get the defensive rebound and went off of her. She has 8 points in the contest. And now substitutions as Kamaria Gatlin will check back in. Gatlin unable, has not scored yet. Gatlin came in for O'Dell. Philoxy looks on the inbound, gets it into Moore. Turn, shot up, no by Moore. Kirsten chased it down. Gives it over to Morgan, and now Morgan almost had the ball taken away from her. Here's Corby. Corby recovered, and a foul call. Let's see. Across the way will be a foul. 42-31, 58 and 2:10 seconds remaining here, third quarter.
Come on, touch her.
Morgan fouled as she was going up off of the inbound. So crossover got it down to 9. And now here as we end the third quarter, the Gauchos trying to push the lead back out. It's up to 11 now and close this third quarter strong. Philoxy looks on the inbound, gets it into Corby. Corby, pass was almost stolen. Here's Morgan. Morgan going to drive, kick it to the corner. Graves, a 3, front iron, no. Rebound, kick back out. They dive for it on the floor. Crossover is going to come away with it with Archie. Archie with her head up with 44 seconds, dribbling with the left hand and a foul on Morgan. Zaya Morgan will pick up the foul. Clement, Sabrina Clement will check in. And coming out will be Shanice Graves. Crudup looking on the inbound. Archie. Archie turns at the free throw line. Stops. There's a shot. Rolled off. No good. Rebound by Philoxy. 35 seconds. Morgan gives it over to Corby. High-low action. A Moore layup. Good. Philoxy on the assist. Went high-low. That's Kirsten Moore's first field goal. Long three. Taylor, no good. Rebound to Coleman. Jennifer Coleman stopped. Puts it back up. No good. Philoxy had the rebound and was knocked away from behind. We got a jump ball underneath the basket. Eight and 4:10 seconds. Looking. There's the inbound pass back to Archie. Archie gives it over. Here's Gatlin holding on a back cut. There was Coleman tipped out of bounds off of Moore. It will stay with the crossover. 2 and 18 seconds. Inbound pass, Coleman catch, fires a three, no, out of bounds, and that will be the end of the third quarter. So they cut the lead down to 13 points, 44-31. The Gauchos leading, crossover Archie. Fourth quarter action coming up next in just a moment. Crossover hoops, Arncy trying to make a comeback. The Gauchos lead 44-31. Joel Hillsman, Chris Watkins, as we start the fourth quarter here from the PSB Tip-Off Classic in Lawrenceville, Georgia, Central Gwinnett High School. There's a three by Corby, back iron, no. Rebound comes down to Lindenfeld, out of bounds, and it will go to crossover hoops. A crossover at 1 point, trail by 20, and actually closed at third quarter, technically on an 11-4 run. But they trail now by 13. Lindenfield, a three. Good. Trail by 10 now. Three ball, Christina Lindenfield. Her first field goal. She has five in the contest. Here's Falassi. Selena goes down the lane, flips it up. No, she'll go to the free throw line. She has had herself a pretty strong game. 20 points in the contest for Selena Falassi, 23 in white, and she's going to the free throw line. Six of nine from the free throw line today, and she'll miss that one, so she's 6 of 10. Started strong, hitting her first five, but now has struggled since then, and now she's 6 of 10. Clement will come in, and Graves will take a seat for the New York Gauchos. Second free throw is good. 21 in the game now for Falassi. Lindenfield tried to feed it out of bounds. That was Kennedy Maddox who was checked in, and a turnover. Kennedy Maddox is on along with Michaela Montgomery, Christina Lindenfield, Bailey Hodges, and Jessica Norman, the five on the floor for crossover Archie, and they are in the blue with the orange numbers. Here's Corby into the forecourt over to Morgan. Morgan holds on that left wing, puts it on the floor, goes around the screen, right-hand drive all the way up the window, no good. Rebound ripped down by Montgomery. Montgomery outlets and gives it to Hodges. Hodges into the forecourt, spins it over to Lindenfield. Stop, left wing, three, Lindenfield. Boom!
Here we go.
Warming to the task, Christina Lindenfield. It's an 8-point game. It's as close as they've been, 45-37. Morgan drives, kick to the corner. Graves, a three, back iron, no. Rebound, hit the floor. Corby, rebound, another three, back iron, no. Lindenfeld on the glass. Christina Lindenfeld off the bench, providing a spark. There, here comes Hodges. Hodges with the right-hand dribble to Lindenfeld. Stop, a three, bang! All three of them, Christina Lindenfeld. She is warm to the task. It's a 5-point game.
Talk about a heat check right there.
It's a 20-5 run by crossover hoops, and now the bench is into it. 2 minutes gone by fourth quarter. Graves holding it now back over to Corby. They pitch and catch on the right wing. Graves, a jumper, no good. Rebound to Montgomery. Montgomery to Hodges. The bench now has gotten Archie back in the contest. There's a pass down low. Pump fake and a foul call, and a foul on Selena Falassi. So going to the free throw line will be Kennedy Maddox, an opportunity to cut it down to two. It's time for a PSB instant replay. Christina Lindenfeld warming to the task and using that long ball. She now has 11 in the contest. Three threes here, all of them here in this fourth quarter. Montgomery, free throw, no good. Excuse me, Maddox. Kennedy Maddox, 6'2", Lloyd Seabird High School. Second free throw. Oh, air ball, no good. So unable to chop it down some more. 20-5 run since it was trailing by 20. It was 40-20. Coaching staff continuing to get into it. Coach Archie's staff. Here's Corby over to Morgan. A left wing three. High Arthur. Back iron. No. Rebound tipped and stolen away. Lindenfeld comes away with it. Lindenfeld gets it up ahead now. And here is Norman. Jasmine Norman swings it over to Hodges. Hodges back to Norman. She's between the rings. Back over on the left side. There's Hodges. It goes on a back cut. Looking for Maddox. Kick it back out. Norman a jumper.
Oh, goodness.
Good. A two, Jasmine Morgan, her first field goal, 5-5 out of Monacan High School. It's a three-point ball game.
Got to get a good shot here if you're the Gauchos.
Morgan, a lot of their shots have gone off the hill of the rim. Morgan swings it over to Graves, touch pass over to Corby. Flash now, might have to play through Philoxy. Philoxy spins, turns, shot up and one. Selena Philoxy, big time move. By a big time player. She had 23. That's a PSB instant replay.
Now, we talked about this earlier. Crossovers made this run. They've got back in it. They got to get one more stop, and now you've got to want to put the dagger in. Okay, you've got to put the in and cap that run.
Free throw, back iron. They struggle. Back tap. They'll get a second chance. Philoxy, jumper, no. Rebound again underneath Moore, and she was fouled. So now the Gauchos beginning to pick up the nit and grit, getting the loose balls, the 50-50 balls, and going to the line will be Kirsten Moore, 5'9", Mount Vernon, out of Mount Vernon in New York. So Odell and Gatlin will come back in here. Moore's free throw is good. Moore with her first free throw. She's 1 of 1 on the day, 3 points. Montgomery will come out, and Maddox will come out. Gave them solid minutes there to start this fourth quarter. 4:47 to go. Moore second free throw. Good rotation. Knocks it in good. She has 4 points. Push the lead back out to 7. Long lead pass and a turnover. Jasmine Morgan, an ill-advised pass and a turnover.
We don't need it.
49-42. They pushed it and got it to 3. Corby over to Moore. Moore holds. Going to drive. Baseline. Picked up the dribble. Bounced it back over to Corby. Corby to Moore. Sets her feet. A corner three. Good. Kirsten Moore. Bang home her three. Her first three of the day. They pushed the lead back out to 9. And now a turnover. They fight for it on the floor and a foul. Let's see. Will the foul be called on? They may have an injury. Let's see. I'm going to get up Corby down there. Slow to get upside Corby. Foul called on crossover. A turnover. So now a 6-0 run here by the Gauchos. They're going to come down and shoot free throws. It'll be the 1-1 coming up. All right. So Shy Corby will go to the free throw line. She is 1 of 1 on a day. She has 9 points. Goes through a free throw routine, sticks it up front end of the 1-1 is good. Brandon Clay has now joined me. And Clay, a 20-5 run by crossover, cut it to 3.
Everybody
and
back.
Now an 8-0 push by the Gauchos to open their lead back up, make it a 9-0 push as Corby gets her second free throw. She's 3 of 3.
Well, this is the type of basketball you expect from PSB family members, you know, teams that we brought underneath our umbrella that bring multiple teams to events. This is exactly what you expect to see in terms of the style of play, the efficiency of play, and honestly, the talent level on the floor.
Opening championship game here on SUV TV. Brandon Clay, I'm Joel Hillsman. That's Zaya Morgan. Her three is no good. Offensive rebound, put back, no. Selena Philoxy has had a whale of a day, 23 points. Struggled a bit from the free throw line of late, but man, what she has been able to do when they ran that offense through her has been phenomenal.
Well, and you talk about the way that the Gauchos like to play traditionally. They've got current Georgia Tech player Zaire O'Neal on the bench And the way that they're playing in terms of running things through Selena reminds me a lot of how they ran things through Zaire back in her day. So, you know, no stranger to the club circuit and Earl Elliott and his group. They do a fantastic job. One of the better teams from the Northeast year in, year out.
7 of 13, as we've talked about the struggles of Phylloxi at the free throw line. She'll have one more. So now, after starting 5 of 5, she struggled. Second free throw, no good. She's dipped all the way to 50% now. And a bad turnover right there by Crossover. Crossover has used that energy, cut it down to 3, a 9-0 run now, lead now pushed back out to 12.
Well, when you look at what, you know, Coach Archie and his club have done over the past couple of years, growing the brand, the program there in the Virginia area, and they have legitimately given kids another opportunity. I mean, you look at that back line of schools, and it's just packed out, you know, for a Sunday from Texas A&M to Radford. Campbell's in the house. There's so many different types of schools and levels of play. Auburn, NC State here today, South Florida in the building, East Carolina, VCU, ODU. I mean, you name it, and they're here. And that's what Coach Archie and his group have done. And if they're out here competing against one of the best programs from the Northeast, can't ask for much more.
I was telling Hemi this again as I settle in. It's nothing like PSB basketball. And of course, I've talked about it with Chris. I'm going to talk about it with you as well, the change to the quarters as we mirror the college game there. But it's just April. It's just April. So a lot in store coming down the line. Phylloxi missed another free throw.
There she goes. She got a nice one there. And, yeah, I'm looking forward to next weekend, Tip-Off Classic Session 2. You know, just another great group of teams, very diverse field, tons of PSB family members. And again, when you talk about the college coaches and just the opportunity to sit in this setting and watch great talent play against and with each other, as we see Rebecca Ripley check back in right here, number 21, going to Miami. So no shortage of players and talent here at the PSB Tip-Off Classic.
Arnae Taylor will check in a moment here for Crossover. Kicked on the baseline. There's more shot up, and a foul by Lindenfeld is good.
It's tough.
Lindenfeld shot them back into this game with three threes to open up this fourth quarter. Substitution, Lindenfeld will go out. Gatlin will check in. Taylor checks in. Crudup in as well, along with Archie and Jennifer Coleman.
Well, literally, you're talking about a team full of scholarship players on both sides there. Archie's already committed to VCU, and then a whole host of kids around her that can play, and the same thing for the Gauchos.
Trapped in the corner by the Gauchos, and a turnover. Oh, no, timeout call. Coach Archie was able to get the timeout in. You talked about Archie already committed to Virginia Commonwealth. I like her game. She's been very balanced with her game today. I think she has their high-end points, although they have struggled. She has 8 points, so she's not the team leader. But she has looked very fluid, and kind of at one point, it was a 5-point game. It's been a game of runs for the most part, but she was very fluid in her point when she put in her buckets.
Well, and I know one thing Coach Archie's talked about with her is continuing to work her back. You know, she's had a couple of knee injuries, a couple of setbacks in terms of the time on the floor. So just getting her back into a groove this year, and by the time July is here, that honestly, Joel, is when we're going to see the best of Archie in that regard. So the best yet to come. Period.
Not sure what the conversation is about.
Hey, whatever it is, everybody get it cleared up, and we're ready to go.
They pushed the lead quickly all the way back out to 17. And the thing about it, it is a 14-0 run.
Well, then, you know, you talked about, obviously, the points coming, you know, for the Gauchos, but they've done it through a lot of different kids. You know, they've obviously got quality production in a couple of spots, but they've got multiple kids who have a bucket here, bucket there.
Rebound, Crudup offensively put it up, no and a foul. The heavy lifting, yeah, has been Selena Phylloxi, but she's had help from Rebecca Ripley, Kirsten Moore, and Shy Corby. Crudup going to the free throw line with 2:38 to go in the contest. Sierra Crudup, 5-7 on a Highland Springs, and the free throw is good, and that ends the run.
I really enjoyed watching her last year at the Real Deal in the Ville. last July. Credit that is. Her willingness to push the tempo. They had a couple of great games up there. They played Lady Phoenix, Delaney Rudd, Best Choice, who we'll see here in a little bit. And that was the thing that was consistent throughout for Credit, is her energy, athleticism, and ability to make a play, especially in the open floor.
Trying to break the press and be patient with it is Aya Morgan with 2.5. Morgan stop and a jump ball call, or we're going to have the timeout. Going to give him the. Let's see. Here's the
refs conference.
Timeout. They will give him a timeout. So the Gauchos got the timeout. 15-point lead with 2.5 to go.
That's a good call. Referee sitting right in front of the bench there. Was able to hear Coach Elliott get that timeout call in.
And it's another thing, Brandon, since you're here now, we see the refs going over. We go to the three-man crew, and now the evaluation. Another thing of what makes PSB wonderful in the event now, up in the referee.
Well, what's great is that you've got, a lot of times you see this, and you think, oh, man, it's a training camp. And these are veteran seasoned officials, most of whom are trying to break into the college ranks. They've been doing high school varsity. They actually have an officials camp. Bill Smith there is leading that instruction in the warm-up jacket. He calls ACC, SEC, all the highest levels of the game. And now he's giving back and giving these referees an opportunity to blaze that same path at the college level. Half of the camp has already been in the Division II, III NAIA level. The other half trying to break in. They're referees that we have, similar to Rico Bruce, who's always on staff with us, and just trying to continue to grow their game, no different than the players out here on the hardwood.
When I see a college game and I see Bill Smith reffing, I know it's going to be a pretty good game. There's a drive for Foxy scooping with the right hand. A beautiful move. Selena Foxy, South Shore, 6 foot. She has done a wonderful job.
Ooh, back at you.
Three ball.
He up now. Hey, you got a shooter there, Cam.
Corby in the backcourt, 2 minutes to go. Corby comes across the lane. Corby gonna go down the right lane and one. Took the contact from Sydney Archie and one.
Well, and that goes back to what I was saying a minute ago. Obviously, they've gotten a ton of production from Selena, but the other kids have been able to make plays and make shots. And that, in the bigger scheme of this, is what's allowed them to really stretch this lead.
Tashay Corby at the free throw line, 5'6". She's out of South Shore as well in Brooklyn, New York. Goes through a free throw routine. Free throw is off. No good. Missed the first free throw. She has 13 in the game. Archie with the rebound. Pulls a three, back iron, no. Tip, good hustle and a save. It'll still be out of bounds and stay with crossover. So crossover made a push, trailed 40-20, got it to 45-42. And since then, have taken off on them again, the Gauchos, and got back to what they were doing. They really moved the ball well. They scored in multiple ways, Brandon, in this ball game. I know you've been paying attention to it, but still, offensive rebound. They scored with defense in transition. They scored via the three ball, and then they scored at the free throw line.
Well, I think you said it best, honestly, Joe, when you talked about it being a game of runs. And in this game in particular, it really has been that. Now, crossover continues to make shots that will not let them go away and giving them an opportunity. And if you guys watch the NCAA tournament, you know that anything's possible. As long as the game is within about 17 with 2 minutes to go, you can always pull a Texas A&M, man.
I know, that's right. That's what makes basketball special. You can sit there and think you got it, and all it takes is a couple hoops and a stop. And here you go, an opportunity here now to get it to 10 with 73 seconds. A floater, no, from the free throw line. Rebound comes down to Foloxi. Don't think that's the shot there that Coach Archie wanted. Here's Morgan. Morgan into the forecourt, a minute to go. 12-point lead.
That's good basketball there to pull it out. She was there in traffic, didn't have anything easy, and just pulled it right back out. Now she gets a chance to handle the basketball.
Has been heady with the ball all day, has Ben Zaya Morgan, number one, and now foul coming out. The foul will be on the Gauchos. And it will send Selena Foloxi to the free throw line for the 1-1 with 46-4, 10 seconds. So the Gauchos withstood The 20-5 run put a run together of their own. Philoxy struggling here later from the free throw line. No good. Sydney Archie got the rebound. Pass was deflected. And they'll come up this way in the final 40 seconds into Gatlin. Gatlin.
Oh, nice.
The window. Good. Good catch and went off the window by Kamaria Gatlin. 6-1 out of Holland Springs.
Crossover Hoops got us started against J.D. Davis from the Hoop Stars on Friday morning. And I really liked Gatling's game in that contest. Her energy level, her willingness to play around the rim, rebounded and finish it. And the Gauchos had a quality game against Team Elite Pointer. Lost, and honestly was a tough game. They were literally just getting out of the van right before the game. But over the course of the weekend, we started to see signs of why Coach Elliott's so excited about this team. And same thing for Coach Archie with this group. Both of them have plenty of talent and things to build on. At the end of the day, like you said, it's just April. So all these teams are playing for late July, put themselves in a position to be really, really good Summer Invitational July 23rd through the 25th and events like those.
A turnover there. 10-point ball game, 20 and 6, 10 seconds. A crossover made their push, got it down to three. The Gauchos withstood it and pushed it back out, used them a nice 15-0 run in there after that to answer that 20-5 run. Corby got the pressure and a turnover. Taylor with the steal, gets it up ahead to Coleman, no good. Rebound by Crudup, and Crudup will go to the free throw line with 9 and 4, 10 seconds. Free throw is no good. And a timeout call. Let's see, is he going to get the time? 4 and 8, 10 seconds. Corby hustling down on the floor. Let's see if they'll give him the time. And a 10-point game. Selena Philoxy with 26 points in the game to lead the Gauchos.
Not a bad day in the office.
12 for Rebecca Ripley. Crudup goes baseline, float up, no, and a foul again. Underneath. 13 for Tashai Corby. And 11 for Kirsten Moore.
It's only like a second it came off.
And just the clock and put 3.2 on the clock. 10-point ball game. No window dressing here to close out the ball game here for Crudup. Sierra Crudup. Six of 10 from the free throw line today is Crudup. Free throw is good. Well, now 7 of 11. Two field goals. She hit a three and she got a deuce. And most of her damage has came right here from the stripe. Missed that free throw. Rebound put back up by Crudup. No, and we've reached the end of the ball game. It is a 62-53 victory for the New York Gauchos over Crossover Hoops Archie. More championship action coming up next right here from the PSB Tip-Off Classic on the SUVTV.com.